Hey guys, it's Troy. You know, every so often, when I look at vintage pens, I'll get one that I'm looking at and I really wanted to add to my collection, whether it be from a pen show, or whether it be from seeing a reviewer cover it, or whether it be that I saw it online. Well, the past couple of pen shows I've been to, Wahl-Eversharp has been on site with their newer pens, but I wanted to check out some of their older stuff. So I had done a little bit of research, a little bit of looking online, and was trying to target some Wahl-Eversharp older stuff. And I'd been chasing a couple of pens on eBay, and I looked at some websites. I wasn't quite willing to pay what they were wanting for a good vintage pen. I've seen some that have been restored, some not restored, and quite honestly, even the restored pens still had a price point that was comparable to some of the unrestored, so I was going after the better ones. And so I was chasing down a Wahl-Eversharp Skyline, and while I've been looking at them and trying to get one, lo and behold, Matt Armstrong with a Pen Habit did a review on his that he had picked up, and it's like, oh, that's interesting. I mean, I've been looking at those and I've been trying to get one. So I continued to chase them down. I'll tell you what I'll do. I'll put a link to Matt's well-done review of the Wahl-Eversharp for the Skyline. And I finally got one. Here's the interesting thing that I found when I was looking at the pens on eBay. And yeah, I unfortunately for me, eBay still sometimes is the place where I'm going to have to get a lot of my stuff, even though I've had ups and downs, hits and misses. This one I'd consider a hit. There was a seller, and I looked at several, and he had one that he had put a new sack on it. So, you know, they're a lever filler pen. Replacing a sack's not a hard thing. I've done it many times myself. So whether or not it had a good sack or not, as long as the pen was in good condition, I was interested. He put some low-resolution pictures, couldn't see very well, but he had a pretty good description. So I went ahead and decided to take the risk. And he had a make offer, or best offer. So I went ahead and made a best offer, and we went back and forth, and we agreed on a price. And the interesting thing is, for me, this may not be of interest to anybody else, the seller was in a tiny little town in New Hampshire. Some 700 miles from where I am, little town called Fremont. We're talking, this was a one stoplight town when I used to live there when I was young. We lived there when I was wee little and lived next to some neighbors with whom I still keep in touch on Facebook anyway. And until I think, you know, my father had a stroke, we had moved as a family up to another town in New Hampshire where the rest of my dad's family was from in that area. So we went and moved up that way. But this tiny little town of Fremont, I said, now that's pretty cool. So I took an interest and I went ahead and I purchased the Wahl-Eversharp Skyline. And like I said, this is one I've been looking at for a while. The Eversharp Skyline was put out between 1941 and 1950, so a 9-year period of time. And the whole idea was they had hired an engineer who helped streamline locomotives back during the 40s. And I'll dig up a picture of a streamlined locomotive so you can see it. But the whole idea was for it to kind of look like a streamlined train engine. So if you can imagine that. So trying to make it look more modernistic. And there are three different sizes. There's the demi model, which is the smallest. There's the standard, which is this. And then there's the executive. The executive models are less numerous. They're harder to come by. Going to be more expensive. But that's my next Wahl-Eversharp that I'm going to look at getting is the executive model. Every once in a while, you get a pen that you just love. And I got to tell you, I freaking love this pen. This is one of my favorites so far of the ones I've gotten. I've been using it for a little while, and the more I use it, the more I love it. This particular pen, it wasn't fully restored when I got it. Like I said, it did have a new sack put in it. you've got the black down here, but you know what? In the right light, it's actually a dark, dark, extremely dark green. So it's not really black. And you see, I polished it up some on the barrel. I may still yet do some more polishing because I used one particular process. I got another process I'm going to try. But I went ahead and used a jeweler's cloth on here. Now here you've got the gold striping, the metal gold stripe that's horizontal. Now that is actually a very common finish on this particular pen. And then you've got the clip here that comes up and goes over the top. So it's actually a fairly functional, let me put it this way, because I got thumbnail on this side. It's a very functional clip. It's stiff. This cap here on the finial, it will unscrew. It's plastic here or a resin of some sort, and you can unscrew this, and the clip comes with it right off the top of the pen. Now, when I got it, this particular section, this gold section here, is just a sleeve that goes on the cap. And I've seen this before with some other pens as well. I've got the same deal with an old Waterman that I've got. And so this sleeve actually was able to come off. You can see where it had been glued on in the past, probably in the 1940s. And so it came off on me. I was like, yeah, okay, that's no big deal. So I polished this up fairly decently with a jeweler's cloth because all I had was just the roundness of it. And I was able to get that, a decent shine on that, better than it was. And then what I found is the barrel and the section actually on this separate pretty easily. And the one thing, I looked at the sack. Okay, the sack installation was okay. It was not, however, talced up. So I went ahead and put talc powder on it. And this one does not have the teardrop style nib on it. I don't know if you can see it. Maybe I'll get some good pictures here in a little while that I'll put up, just because, you know, with my camcorder, it's kind of hard to get that. But it's it's a little shorter than I like here, but it can still be held in the hand, and it's got more of a fine nib to it. When you cap and post it, one of the neat things is you'll see that you've got your lever here. The cap comes down, it just about covers the entire lever, so it posts fairly deeply. And it backweights the pen just a little bit, but not too much, and it extends the length of it just enough where it actually feels better in my hand than it was previously. When I went to go write with the pen, it actually wrote fairly well. I liked what I saw. And I inked it up with, some Birmingham Pens Midnight Horizon ink. Because it's a lever filler, and lever fillers, in my experience, work better filling out of a bottle rather than all these samples I've got. I'm not even a fan of lever filler pens, but I am a fan of some vintage pens, and if you're going to get a vintage pen, guess what? You're probably going to run across a lever filler at one point or another. So you got the screws here. The one thing I don't like about this, I mean, you got plenty of room. You're not going to feel the screw, the screw grooves for the cap when you're using it. So actually, it fits perfectly in the hand. It does not have a problem. You know, it tapers down towards the end. Then you get this little flare, so you know when you're at the end of your section. The one thing I don't like about it, there are three different ways or so that this thing can thread. So if it takes one and almost a full, see now it's aligned. So the clip and the lever, which is just, I know I'm OCD about it, but at least now it aligns better than it did, because I had taken this part off here and put it back on, and it would never align at first. So you can have this you'll have this clip. It can be on any one of like three different positions depending upon where you are when you start screwing it together. But I've got it so after working with the clip and the top screw of that, it actually lines up fairly well. This baby here, it needed just a hair bit of smoothing. It already wrote well, but I said, you know, let me check tine alignment. And the alignment was okay, just a quick little, and I got that just a little better aligned. And then I went, you know, now that it's aligned well, it still writes just a tad more scratchy than I want. So just a minute or so with my nib smoothing kit, and now it writes extremely smoothly. So, like I said, I really, really, really like this pen. It is such a great writer now, and it is a stylish looking, simple yet elegant looking pen. I do like vintage pens, and I don't know why I'm on a vintage pen kick here lately where I'm getting a lot of older stuff. I have a great appreciation for the older stuff, the old Watermans. My Waterman collection has been growing. I did not have an Eversharp. I had a couple of Wearevers, but not Eversharps in my collection. And so I decided that I wanted to try some Wahl-Eversharps, especially since I saw the new stuff that was on the market that seemed pretty cool, but I wanted to have an appreciation for the older style. I don't know what it is, just the 1940s and 50s to me seems like a really cool era for pens. That's just my personal opinion. Not everybody's into it, but I've been getting a lot more 40s and 50s pens. This tapers down nicely here at the end. So you got this nice little cone down here. And I can't wait to see when I can get a nice executive model, because I would really, really like to try one. And there are so many different styles and colors that are available. I'll put a link up to a couple of web pages. And these are my go-to pages. So Jim with Pen Trace, he's always got some good articles and some information. And then you've got, of course, Richard Bender's site and his reference pages. He's got some really good materials there as well. I'll put links to those here. And I'll show you how really, really well this thing writes. Okay guys, writing portion here. This again is the Wahl-Eversharp, and you know I probably didn't show it during the first part, but you can see right here it says Eversharp right down here on the clip. So I really have enjoyed this pen thus far, and every time I've picked it up and played with it, it wrote the first time, every time, and very smoothly, especially after I went over it, you know, and smoothed it out just a little bit. And you know, the horizontal gold stripe, I do like that. It's very classy to me. So just to let you know ahead of time, I did fill this with Birmingham Pens Grandview Avenue Midnight Horizon, which is supposed to be like a black-blue type of thing, but it's going to write mostly black in this particular pen. So a couple of turns, only takes about two full turns, and here we go. This is the Wahl. You know, I always mess that up. W-A-H-L. The Wahl, Eversharp. And this is going to be the Skyline. It writes extremely smooth. It writes very well. I've been happy, very happy with this pen. And it's got a little bit of flex. You can probably even see that. So, this pen lays down a lot of ink. Even though it's supposedly like a fine nib, it is a semi-flex nib. And you can see I can get some decent line variation out of it by flexing it. But it also lays down significant ink where it feathers a little bit because it puts down a heap big amount. But it doesn't matter what direction I'm writing in, this pen does a great job. Pretty cool, huh? I'm very happy with this. This is one of the best writers that I've got in my collection, and there is absolutely no arguing for me that this is going to be one of my all-time favorites thus far. It's kind of interesting today, especially considering one of my all-time favorite pens in general, for my pen of the day, today just happens to be in rotation, my Waterman Karen, which is also one of my smoother writers. So I've got a modern, much more rigid nib that's an extremely smooth writer. And then I've got a nice vintage pen from the 40s, so you know, anywhere between 70 and 80 years old, that writes extremely well. So at least I've been getting some good writers here lately when I do get a good one. I've got a few skunks over the past little while, but I'm very pleased. The Wahl-Eversharp Skyline.